Here it is said that Neha took a loan of 50,000 rupees at 12% per annum to buy a two-wheeler. What amount will she return to the bank at the end of 1 year? Now, amount borrowed is equal to the principal amount, which is 50,000. And for the amount borrowed, she has to pay an interest of 12% per annum. That is the rate of interest. And the time duration is 1 year. Now we know that interest is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100. Here we have principal amount, we have the rate of interest, and we have the time, which is 1 year. So when we substitute the value, we get our interest to be 6,000. So when she has to return the amount, it is 6,000 rupees extra to what she has already borrowed from the bank. So the amount that gets returned is principal plus interest, which is 50,000 plus 6,000, that goes to 56,000. So the amount to be returned to the bank is 56,000. Now the next example shows Akash deposited 25,000 rupees in a bank at a rate of 8% per annum for 3 years. So 8% per annum is the interest that the bank will give for using his money, because he's deposited the amount in the bank, and that also for 3 years. How much interest does he get every year? How much all together? Now here amount deposited is equal to the principal, which is 25,000. Rate of interest is at 8% per annum, and the time is 3 years. We know that interest is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100. When we substitute the values given, we get interest as 6,000 rupees. But this 6,000 rupees is the interest that he will get after 3 years. The question asked is, how much interest does he get every year? So amount to be received after 3 years, if it's 6,000, amount received every year will be 6,000 upon 3, which is 2,000 rupees. Now for 1 year, if he receives 2,000, for 3 years he has received 6,000 as interest. So how much altogether is an amount of 6,000 rupees. The next example says Sandeep borrowed 1,20,000 rupees from a bank for 4 years at the rate of 8.5% per annum for his son's education. What is the total amount he returned to the bank at the end of that period? Now here we know principal amount borrowed is equal to 1,20,000, and the interest that rate at which he is going to pay his interest is 8.5 or 8 1 upon 2, 8.5% per annum. Time duration is 4 years. The question asked is, what is the total amount he returned to the bank at the end of that period? So first we'll need to calculate the interest. We know that interest is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100. When we calculate that, we come to find that the interest is 40,800. Now the amount that has to be returned has to be added to the principal amount borrowed. Okay, so the principal amount borrowed is 1,20,000 plus 40,800 the interest. So the total amount to be returned is 1,60,800. Here it says, if Rehana deposited 1,500 rupees in the school fund at 9% per annum for 2 years, what is the total amount she will get? Amount deposited is equal to the principal, which is 1,500. Rate of interest is 9% per annum, and the time given is 2 years. We know that interest is equal to P into R into T upon 100. So when we calculate after substituting the values, we get interest to be at 270 rupees. Amount she will get after 2 years is principal plus interest, which is 1,500 plus 270 rupees, which is 1,770 rupees. That's the total amount she will get after 2 years. Jethalal took a housing loan of 2,50,000 rupees from a bank at 10% per annum for 5 years. What is the yearly interest he must pay and the total amount he returns to the bank? Now, loan taken is equal to the principal amount, which is 2,50,000. Rate of interest given is 10% per annum. Time is 5 years. We know interest is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100. When we substitute the values, we get that interest is equal to 1,25,000. But this 1,25,000 is the interest payable after 5 years. Okay? The question asked is, what is the yearly interest he must pay? So interest paid after 5 years is 1,25,000. So interest paid every year is 1,25,000 upon 5. That is 25,000. So the total amount returned to the bank after 5 years is principal plus the interest, which is 2,50,000 plus 1,25,000. That gives us 3,75,000. The next one says, Shrikant deposited 85,000 rupees for 2.5 years at 7% per annum in a savings bank account. What is the total interest he received at the end of the period? Amount deposited is equal to principal, which is 85,000. The rate given is 7% per annum. Time is 2.5 years. We know interest is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100. On substituting the given values, we find out that interest is equal to 14,875 rupees, which is to be payable after 2.5 years. So total interest he receivable. So total interest he received at the end of the period or at the end of 2.5 years is 14,875. Now, it is said that at a certain rate of interest, the interest after 4 years on 5,000 rupees principal is 1,200 rupees. What would be the interest on 15,000 rupees at the same rate of interest for the same period? So the rate of interest is not given to us, but the year, the time is given. So here we have time, 4 years, principal amount, 5,000. We also know the interest that has been paid, which is 1,200 rupees. We need to calculate the rate. We know the interest formula, which is principal into rate into time upon 100. On substituting the given values, we find out that rate is equal to 6% per annum. Now, the next question says, what would be the interest on 15,000 rupees at the same rate of interest for the same period? So here we have found out that the rate of interest is 6% per annum. We'll use the same rate in the formula, and when we use that for 15,000 as the principal, we find that the interest is 3,600 rupees. The rate of interest is 6% per annum, and the interest on 15,000 rupees at 6% per annum is 3,600 rupees. The next one says, if Pankaj deposited 1,50,000 rupees in a bank at 8% per annum for 2 years, what is the amount he will get from the bank? Amount deposited is the principal, which is 1,50,000, rate is 10% per annum, time is 2 years. We know that the formula is interest is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100. On substituting the value, we get that interest is 30,000 rupees. Okay. Now, amount to receive from the bank after 3 years, after 2 years, is the principal amount plus the interest. So 1,50,000 plus 30,000 is equal to 1,80,000 is the amount receivable after 2 years. Now, the next example shows principal amount is 25,000. Amount is 31,000. The time is 4 years. So what is the rate of interest? Now, we know that amount is equal to principal plus the interest. So, on substituting the values, we get that the interest is 6,000 rupees, which is nothing but amount minus the principal. Now, we know principal is 25,000, interest is 6,000, and the time is 4 years. And we need to find out the rate of interest. On substituting in our formula, which is interest is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100, we find out that the rate is 6% per annum. Rate of interest is 6% per annum. Now here, it's उन्मेश बोरोड सम मनी फॉर 5 years एट सिंपल इंटरेस्ट. द रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज 9% पर एनम. इफ ही रिटर्न 17,400 रुपीज ऑल टूगेदर एट द एंड ऑफ 5 years, हाउ मच हैड ही बोरोड? So what we need to find out is, we need to find out the principal amount that he had borrowed. Now what we can start with saying is, we can say that let the principal be X. We know that amount is equal to principal plus interest. And we also know that end of the year, end of the term, he paid a total of 17,400. So it's a total amount which is inclusive of the principal and interest. We have already stated that let the principal be X. So 17,400 is equal to X plus interest. Now interest will be what? 17,400 minus X. Okay, so we have principal as X and interest as 17,400 minus X from a simple formula of amount is equal to principal plus interest. Now we know that interest formula is principal into rate into time upon 100. On substituting the values that we have just found, we can say that interest, which is 17,400 minus X, is equal to X into 9 into 5, because 5 years is what they have told us. Now when we solve it, we will get 17,400 minus X is equal to 9 into 5 into X, which is 45X upon 100. On sending minus X on the right hand side, X becomes plus. Here 4X upon 100 and plus X, two different fractions. We need to equalize the denominator. Equalizing the denominator is X means X minus X upon 1. So 1 into 100 and X plus 100. So it becomes 17,400 is equal to 45x plus 100x upon 100. On adding, we get 17,400 is equal to 145x upon 100. So our x value is 17,400 into 100 upon 145. When we solve this, it gets, because 17,400 last digit is 0 and 145 last digit is 5, so both are divisible by 5. When we cut it by 5, we get 3480 into 100 upon 29. So what we'll do is, we'll leave the 0 which is there with 3480, club it with 100. So we have 348 into 1000 upon 29. We calculate 29 ones are, and then 5 carry forward, so 29 twos are, which is 58. So 12 into 1000, so 12,000 is our answer. How much had he borrowed? He had borrowed 12,000, because our value of X has come as 12,000, and that's what we had said, our principal is X, which is 12,000. If the interest on 1700 rupees for 2 years is 340 rupees, the rate of interest must be what? Now we have all the requirement, principal, time, interest, rate we need to find out. We substitute in our formula and we get our answer as 10% per annum. The next one says, if the interest on 3000 rupees is 600 rupees at a certain rate, for a certain number of years, what would be the interest on 1500 rupees under the same conditions? Now what we can say, we don't know the rate of interest. So we'll say let the rate of interest be X. But we know that X percent of 3000 is the interest, which is 600 rupees. So we'll substitute X percent, that is X upon 100 of means multiplication, into 3000 is equal to 600. On calculating, we'll get the value of X as 20%, because X is rate of interest that we needed to find. Now the question is, what would be the interest on 1500 rupees under same conditions? We have found out what is the rate of interest, so we'll say A, since conditions are same. Interest on 1500 is 20% of 1500. So 20% of 1500, when we calculate, we get the interest as rupees 300. Now the next one says Javed deposited 12,000 rupees at 9% per annum in a bank for some years and withdrew his interest every year. At the end of the period, he had received altogether 17,400 rupees. Now, for how many years had he deposited his money? So we just jot down whatever basics we know. We know that deposited amount, the principal is 12,000 rupees. The rate of interest is 9%. Okay. For some years, so the time is not known, and withdrew his interest every year. So 9% rate of interest on the principal. So 9% of the principal is our interest. So when we go ahead and calculate 9% of 12,000, we get interest as 1080. So now we have calculated that it's 9% of principal that gives us the interest. So 9% of our principal value, which is 12,000, the interest amount comes to 1080. Every year he received an interest of rupees 1080. Now, end of the period, he received 17,400. Now, 17,400 is his amount. And we know the formula for amount is principal plus interest. So amount 17,400 is nothing but 12,000, which was our principal plus the interest. So your interest can be calculated by subtracting amount from principal from the amount. So 17,400 minus 12,000 is the interest that he has received at the end of the period. Okay, full and final interest amount. So if 1 year, for 1 year he has received 1080, so for how many years has he received the interest of 5400? When we do our cross multiplication, we divide 5400 by 1080 and we get the number 5. So we know that Javed had deposited his money for 5 years. Lata Bain borrowed some money from a bank at a rate of 10% per annum interest for 2.5 years to start a cottage industry. If she paid 10,250 rupees as total interest, how much money had she borrowed? So we have no idea what is the principal amount borrowed, but we know the rate of interest, which is 10% per annum, and we also know that the time duration is 2.5. plus the interest that has been paid after 2.5 years is 10,250 rupees. So we know the formula of interest as principal into rate into time upon 100. On substituting the given values, we find that principal is equal to 41,000. Now principal amount borrowed is rupees 41,000.